got my notepad out and we have some comments from viewers that we're going to discuss in this video right now. I'm Tom Kovichak and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. Like always, I have a Q&A video where I have a bunch of questions on here or comments or even some solutions to things that I've talked about in other videos. But before we get to that, if you would like to see more videos like this, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And while you're at it, ding that bell. And go ahead and check out my playlist where you could find lots of videos on there. I got over 300 videos and they're all categorized for you to find easily. So let's get going with this list that I have right here and we're gonna do it in alphabetical order. Now, by the commenter. So, because that's the way it comes up on the thing here. This is from Bill Fusion Enterprise. Now, this is from the video where I had five alternate methods of finding discounted model railroad supplies and stuff that came out last week. He said, for your information, Rumor Mill has Hobby Lobby dropping the train stuff. Well, I think he's right because we went to Hobby Lobby. We went to two Hobby Lobbies. Last week we went to Trader Joe's and Hobby Lobby's right next door to there. So I took a little video and I'll show it to you right here what they have for the train sets.
Okay, and they're starting to put the discount prices on the train sets here at Hobby Lobby.
Except for that one right there. I don't know why that one. This one's $139. This one here, normally $199, down to $139.
We were up in Fort Myers also last week, so we stopped by the Hobby Lobby there, and this is what I found there.
Okay, here's the Fort Myers Hobby Lobby, $139 for that one. This one's got a sale one for $99.
$179 for the M scale. That one's $139 and Chattanooga. Again, $139 on sale.
They have discount prices on all the HO scale model train sets. The N scales, they didn't have any discounts on it. As far as the other items on there, the shelves look about the same. I didn't see any difference in them. They're not moving stuff out of there. In the clearance, I always find stuff in the clearance. But that's the first one. Okay, let's go to our next one right here. This is from Cat. Comment. Question. I marked a 22-inch radius line on a 4-foot-wide table. I ran the track with the outside ties inside the radius line to have 2 inches clearance on either side of the table. I understand the true radius is less than 22. And you are absolutely correct. The center line of the track is where you measure the radius. So if you have your ties, and assuming that you're doing HO because you didn't say what scale you are in, but assuming you're doing HO, the center line is approximately 5/8 inches in from the outside tie. So you've probably got just a little bit over a 20-inch radius on there. So let's go to the next one. This is from Donald Gilbert. I really want to get into model trains and the whole world of it. I've watched tons of videos on YouTube and sometimes it seems overwhelming and not sure if I can do it. I watch some videos and think to myself, that seems easy, and then I see a couple more and I think, I can't do that, I'm not really sure. Well, I told him, all you gotta do is get started. Start off easy, don't get overwhelmed with it, be patient, do what you can do. That's the most important part of it, is to have fun. Don't get overwhelmed on taking on projects that you can't do. Go at your own pace and work with what you can do. And eventually you'll get better at what you're doing. This is from Edwin Kowalinski. Tom, I need some advice. I just received a brochure from Hawthorne Village offering a Budweiser Christmas train. It's HO scale and DC. I have a DCC system. Do you know if this train can be converted to DCC? It comes with easy track, but I don't know who makes the train. Any advice would be appreciated. What my response was to Edward Kowalinski, another Polish name, and I mess up a name, and my name's just as bad. But anyway, what I told him was, I am not familiar with the Hawthorne Village or the Budweiser Christmas train. I told him to Google it, and he may find some information on it. And I also told him that I don't do those catalogs that come out at Christmas time. I have never bought anything from them, and I stay away from them mainly because a lot of the stuff on there is overpriced. You know, Google it, and I'm sure you'll be able to find somewhere on there where you could find a good price for that same locomotive. It's most likely made by Bachmann, and if it's DC, you could change it over to DCC. It's just a matter of how much work you want to do on it. Mono Railroad fan, is there a way to communicate to JMRI? I mean, not by way of the throttle or the screen or by way of my smartphone. I'm building a DCC++ throttle by Dave Bodner. I have it working with some added functions, but still on the breadboard. This I can connect to the DCC++ base station directly over transmit and receive. I would like to be able to control the screen throttle using my physical throttle so I can look at the layout and not worry where the cursor is all the time. Okay, the key word here is Dave Bodner. He's the one that built the DCC++ throttle. He's the one that you should be asking the question. Go on his website. His email is there, and he answers pretty quickly because I emailed him a couple of months ago, and he got back with me within the same day. So that's my question to him. I get a lot of questions like this, that they're working on something, they seen this on somebody else's channel. I says, go ask them. Okay, I can tell you about what I have on my channel, but I can't tell you about what somebody else has on their channel or how it works. You have to go to that channel, ask that person how to do it. And if you're watching on YouTube, you should be able to go to the About page and see their email on there. And if they don't have it posted on there, ask them in the comments. Simple as that. Okay, here's the next one. Richard Van Ray. Now, his comment was from the video where I did the tortoise and the cobalt switch machine comparison. Now, here's what he said. Now, that was some time ago. I think it was maybe 9 or 10 months ago. I would never buy these motors again. I have had nothing but problems. They often need to have their addresses reset, and I have to check optically if the points have changed, as I cannot trust them. To power the signals is very complicated compared to tortoise motors. I honestly feel that I have wasted, and this is AU$600, I guess that's Australian. The spring clips that do not require soldering are a pain. They are too close together, and if you don't have the wire perfectly stripped, you just have to bump it or have a stray strand and it will short circuit or pull out. I would prefer to have a solid solder fit. I wish I had not bought them. And he's talking about the cobalt switch machine. And I agree with you, Richard, 100%. The spring clip on there, they are on there for people that don't like to solder or don't know how to solder. They make it a little bit easier, but the things are so small that you really have to be careful with them. And that's all I'm going to say about it, because I have tortoise switch machines all over my layout here. I think I have about 18 of them here, and that's what I'm going with. I have one cobalt that I tried out, and that's in a box someplace right now. So thank you. Okay, Willie Van Straten, S-T-R-A-A-T-E-N. Hi, Tom. I bought my trains about 40 years ago. Me and my son used to play a bit. Then we had to pack it up again and put it away because we didn't have the space to permanently build a layout. I watched your video and read through all the comments. My question is, can I use the 12-volt output to drive the DC locomotives? If I build some type of speed controller between the power supply and the rails. Thanks, Willie. Bloom 14, South Africa. Okay, the power supply that I did the video on is good for driving your accessories. It has 3.3 volt, has 5 volt, it has 12 volts. And it has a minus 12, and some of them have a minus 5 volt on them, depending on how new or old they are. But I wouldn't recommend trying to operate your locomotive on there. What I told him is, most transformers that run your locomotive start out at about 16 volts. Now he replied back and he says, well, he checked his at 12 volts. He was trying to operate two locomotives and it just died on him. And I told him that's probably why, because those were built for just one train, not two. The transformers and power supplies that you buy today are normally 16 volts and up, depending on the scale that you're at. Not quite sure about South Africa, but here in the States, I mean, you could pick up power supplies pretty inexpensively anywhere. And I've had this question asked several times. It's not just Willie, but a few other modelers asked me about that also. And I tell them the same thing, that the power supply that we used was for accessories. Now that's all of them, I think. Let me see. My thing says 7 out of 7, and that's it. That's all the comments and questions I have. I had another one from the email. I can't remember what his name was, but we went back and forth, and I told him I was gonna do a video on this. And he was talking about the Arduino Made Easy Lesson 7, where I had the infrared sensor in the track operating the LEDs lights for the crossing. Apparently he has a ready-made crossing, so, and he has double tracks, so he wants 4 IR sensors and he wants to operate a relay with it. And I told him I'll be doing a video on that, and that's gonna be one of the videos coming up pretty shortly, putting 4 IR sensors in the track and using the IR sensors to operate a relay instead of flashing the LEDs. That's it for all the questions, the answers, the comments, and everything else. Keep those comments coming, because I like to see those comments. I like to answer those comments. And if I don't know the answer, I'll tell you that I don't know it, and I'll point you in the right direction to somebody that does know the answer to it. And hopefully they can answer the question. So, until the next time.